Hello, and welcome back to The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, where today we're doing the intro from the pause screen because we apparently only have a very short window between rains at this point. But I want to try and run this blue flame as far as I can in the time we have. So, we're getting to it. Just going to make sure to also light these along the way, because checkpoints are good. And moblins are jerks. The light, please. Okay. Let's use this. Okay, that worked like a charm. Apparently his weapon has caught blue flame. Not that that changes anything. Where's our next stop? Maybe... there's a lantern. Hi, choo-choos. I don't want to play with you right now. Wow, we, should have taken the path to get up. Could have potentially saved ourselves some moblins. But hey. He's not fast enough to cause us many problems. Especially not when he takes that long to swing. This is a neat little body of water. I'm sure it's got some things hiding around it. Because what in this game doesn't have things hiding around it, really? Moblin there, moblin there. So many moblins. Thankfully, he is apparently not hanging out next to his weapon. And so, we're able to get on by, kind of. Don't you dare, wolves. I've got fire. See? I may have caused a problem. Sounds like the moblin gave up. Uh-oh. That's right. That existed, didn't it? Oh. This is a problem. Ooh, that was close. Okay. There we go. Okay. So, as long as we can light this without being spotted. Excellent. We are okay. Apparently we had more time between rains than I thought, but still. Oops.
Mipha's grace is ready.
Oh, that's nice. So I can't help but notice it says times one for Mipha's grace. Does that mean that we can have more than one stocked? Hey, I did your thing. Yeah, the furnace is lit. Ooh. So is that why they're called ancient arrows and were already called so when I grabbed the first one from someone who wasn't you? Okay. I did. Oh. Okay, what can we get from you? Expensive things, eh? Whoa. That's neat looking, but costly. Kind of want to make the armor just to have it. Also, Guardian Resist Up sounds pretty nice. Not gonna lie. Okay. Let's not read that for now. Anything hanging out up here? This place sure is a bit of a shanty. Though I do like that Robbie's and what's her name's research labs have unique structure. Oh. How much can I search? Just three times for this massive pile? Okay, that's more like it. Though I imagine this pile was collected by Robbie over there. Oh, I was just trying to search for parts, but apparently I accidentally picked up a rock, and it was a good rock to pick up. Yeah, I can't imagine why Robbie would have left all these parts just hanging around in this pile of guardians. Grain. Barely made it up there. Oh, hey, squirrel. This rain would make it tough to get back up here from where the Korok is hanging out. And I imagine gliding is certainly necessary. Do you only slide down once, or is it... It's once in a while. Well, that's a problem. That's a waste. Interesting that that can kick in for fatal falling damage. Oh, this is a skull-shaped rock. Those tend to have occupants. Ow. I don't want to be fighting with my torch right now. That's a bad idea. Yeah, let's use our mighty Lionel spear. After all, it is mighty. And what were you fellas hiding in here? Couple barrels and a chest. Chest ain't fantastic. I was kind of hoping they would break against each other. Don't know what you were doing in there. Oh, that's how rain's falling inside. Apparently, I might have been supposed to take this path instead of the path I actually took. Nice try. Yeah, Yeah, stasis is very good against moblins. I wonder if... I don't think anything is gained by lighting all of these, but part of me is curious. Maybe something is gained by doing so. You're okay, Fox. I'm not touching you. Oh, the rain stopped. Which means we can actually attempt the Korok challenge over here. We just gotta find that leaf. There it is. So, we step on here. And then we go. Gotta get to there. We'll probably end up using some of our stamina restoratives. In fact, we definitely will, because I'm going to do a little bit of jumping. Hopefully I didn't just screw myself over. Yeah, sure. Okay, good. Yeah, I was worried that accidentally using up all the stamina wouldn't let us immediately keep holding on just because we got back to full from an item. So... Korok, help! Clearly I was meant to use an updraft of some sort. But hey, I'm alive. Goodbye. So we fell all the way down, huh? Yep, we sure did. Ooh, that looks different. Why is this place teeming with moblins? What are they guarding? Apparently these fallen pillars are nothing special. There we go. I spy some ore spots. It's been a while since we've hit any of those. What is that? Let's put that right there to encourage any ore to come flying over this way. A labyrinth, it seems. Yeah, definitely a labyrinth, though we have the whole map right here, so that kind of defeats its purpose of being a labyrinth. Yeah, if we could just get in, we'd be able to find our way all the way through it. That might actually be worth doing. Though, what is defined as all the way through it? Because apparently unless like these have entrances to that big box, there is no obvious end. Maybe all the dead ends have something. Maybe none of them do. I think I can wait to figure it out. Because we have got still more shrines to do that we have already marked. Huh. I guess this is the northern edge of the map. Alright, so if we go here, we can probably glide down to that one. Or we could go to Kakariko Village and maybe also glide down to it. But let's do it from here. Better view from Lanayru Tower. Okay, getting our bearings. So is that the shrine? Yes, it is. That is indeed the blue one. And then we can head over to purple from there. Is that the purple one? No, that's sun reflecting off of water, apparently. So there's a tower. That might be worth going to. Just not for a while. We've got shrines to hit first. Ah, there's the purple shrine, and then there's a tower beyond it. Though that might be a ways beyond it. That tower does seem pretty tiny from here. So many towers we haven't hit. Four of them visible in this shot alone. We gotta try and get over land. We don't want to land in water, because then we may end up drowning. And that is something that I'd imagine is best avoided. There we go. Oh, hi. Yeah, have fun with that. Oh, bull, help. Whoa there, ancient arrow. That's not how to select arrows. Oh. So that is an instant kill. No, you don't. I've had enough electric geese for a lifetime. That guardian definitely gave a lot of loot. Do guardians get revived by the blood moon? Seems kind of silly if they do. At least we can play baseball with these electric keys. Dakatus. Who cares about Lizulfos when you can take an elevator? Sunken Scoop. So, yes indeed. So am I going to take that thing and put it in there? That's what it looks like I'm going to do. Oh. So it's like a vessel of water? No. Do you hold water? You don't seem to hold water. Oh! Oh! I get it! I get it! I get it! I get it! It's sunken scoop because we scoop up the balls, though we need to actually get it below the balls. And then we take the balls and we somehow drop them in there. Yes, that is what we do. And then, considering that there remain balls in this pool, I imagine we bring another one with us. Whoops. Oh, so now they float? Or did they always float? Yeah, that they did always float. They were not underwater at all. Oh, I didn't need to take this one. Well, that's fine. Oh. Okay, so that can stay there. Looks like we need to press the button down there. This camera is not great. So does this press the button? It does. And that opens up, and since I already had a ball on it, we already win. It's called thinking ahead. Though really, it's more like making assumptions. Okay, good. It didn't. Okay, I guess we're maybe not supposed to bring this with us. But that's too bad. It's here now. Is there no chest in this shrine? Where would there be a chest? There's no chests in there. No chests. Ah, wait. Chest. Apparently this water got drained at the same time. That silver longsword doesn't seem bad. Let's go ahead and replace something. So when am I going to get the ability to, like, reinforce my weapons to have more durability? Because that seems like a thing that would be helpful. Give me your orb. So as much as I want to go to the purple one right now, it's past time. But we're going to do a little bit of upkeep. Going to head over to the Temple of Time to get ourselves some upgrades. Probably stamina again. And then we'll go to Kakariko Village, see if maybe we can upgrade any equipment at the Great Fairy Fountain and get some more fairies while we're at it. And I still need to find the Korok Woods. I really wish that laser wasn't there at all times. Kinda takes away from the beauty of the environment. So, Temple of Time is that away. Well, made it a good chunk of the way. There aren't that many enemies between us and our goal. And the ones that are here are basically nothing. If I were to swing my weapon at them, they would die instantly, I'm sure. Is that? Let's use the shrine and hopefully it'll still be there. Stamina. Yeah, we only really need more health if we're going up against particularly tough enemies. And as long as they don't one-shot us, then we can just keep eating food. So yeah, I'm not going to go for hearts until we've completed our second stamina wheel. What is that? Wonder how far away it actually is. Yeah, it looks like it's really far away. I'm sure it's not safe to encounter, but I'm really curious as to what it is. Well, now isn't the time to find out. Now's the time to go over there. Seems this world still has quite a few mysteries hiding from us. Oh, hi. Thank you. So, let's see what these fairies, greater and lesser, have to offer. That reminds me, there was a glowy spot below that one shrine we went to, like, a couple episodes back now, isn't it? That I was gonna check out, but I didn't actually check out. And I was thinking that it was gonna be a fairy fountain. Yeah, let's see what you can do. Nothing of value. Sorry. Can you call more fairies? Because there was only one here this time. Curiosity's getting the better of me. I want to see whether it really is a fairy fountain up here. Because if it is, fairies are good to have. And if it isn't, then we'll get to find out what it is. And I do like to indulge my curiosity. So it would be down there. What is a glowin'? Mushrooms? Oh, nope, that is definitely a fairy fountain. Oh, don't fly away, fairy. Well, we lost one. But we got two. Sure. Oh. How many? That's quite a bit, but I guess I can afford it. Maybe more people would be willing to approach you if you didn't live in such a thorny flower, by the way. I see you have a different hairstyle. Is that so? I do agree with that. Oh. So you do the same thing. Ooh, but you can enhance different things. Oh, you're the one who's responsible for going level 2 to level 3, apparently. That's fine by me. Let's get some more defense. Is that a different enhancing animation? I think it is. I don't remember the old one, but... Oh. So if I was to go buy the Hylian hat and then upgrade that twice, I could wear the full set to get a set bonus, right? Wonder what the set bonus would even be. And whether it would be worth it. Oh, so it's based on how many great fairies you've helped is how high they can upgrade your stuff. So what kind of flowers we got around here? Oh. That's not bad. Doesn't look like there's anything else going on here. So, we don't want to go there because there's no quick way back. Because this is actually up a cliff from there. But I guess it's not that long to go like that, but meh. Let's just head on over to this shrine and we'll end the episode there. All right, that'll be it for this episode. Join us next time when we make our way to that next shrine and probably another tower. Okay, good. You stay there, buddy. See you then, friends.